We invite all listeners to tune in every Thursday at approximately 7:25 a.m. for Tutor Speaks, a program which deals with all issues affecting teachers, schools, and the education sector in general. So join us right here on I-95.5 every Thursday morning at 7:25. A blessed good morning to all I-95.5 listeners. This is the segment Tutor Speaks, and I am your presenter, Patricia Eversley. This morning, I welcome to the program Mr. Lindsley Dudai, the president of the Trinidad and Tobago Unified Teachers Association, who has for us some comments on a recent situation that occurred at one of the nation's schools. Without further ado, Mr. Dudai.
Good morning, Patricia, and good morning to all listeners of I-95.5. Last week, the country heard the shocking news of the brutal assault of Mr. Jiwan Ramdani, the principal of the Tonopuna Hindu Primary School, in his office by two men who came to the school on the pretext that they were seeking a recommendation from the principal. What the country may not know was that while the principal was speaking to one of the men about the request for a recommendation, the other man pulled out a baton that was hidden in his trousers and dealt him several blows to his head. The principal suffered injuries to his head. The gash he sustained to his head required four stitches after he was rushed by ambulance for medical attention. As this attack happened during a school day, while school was in session, it was certain to result in chaotic scenes as both teachers and students would have feared for their safety and would have been severely traumatized. The teachers of the Tonopuna Hindu Primary School must be commended for their response to this brazen attack. Some of the female teachers, the association was reliably informed, went to the assistance of the principal and attended to him in the aftermath of the attack. They attempted to stop the flow of blood and to wipe away the blood that had already been shed. The association has also been informed that some male teachers even attempted to pursue the perpetrators and then manned the school's gates to ensure the men did not return. Other teachers took on the responsibility of trying to calm and reassure the students who were quite naturally frightened and traumatized by the incident that had just taken place. Tutor commends the teachers of the Tonopuna Hindu Primary School for the high degree of compassion, care, and dedication that they would have displayed in the aftermath of the attack. By their actions on that fateful day, they would have demonstrated that they are deserving of the title of teacher. There was strong condemnation from many persons to this cowardly act. Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley, in condemning the attack, described it as one of the worst criminal actions to have taken place here within recent times because of the far-reaching consequences. Education Minister Anthony Garcia condemned it as a despicable act of violence perpetuated against a principal that must be condemned in its strongest terms by society. Head of the Sanatan Dharma Mahasabha, Satnaraj, also condemned the actions of the attackers. He said it was unfortunate that such violence has reached within a primary school and shows the type of society Trinidad and Tobago has become. The Trinidad and Tobago Unified Teachers Association joins in strongly condemning the attack on the principal of the Tonopuna Hindu Primary School. Acts such as these must not be tolerated, for adults are expected to behave in a more responsible manner and set the proper example for our nation's children. The association is thankful that Mr. Ramdani was not more seriously injured or even killed. It was widely reported that the entry of the attackers onto the school's compound and the actual assault was captured on CCTV footage. As the footage has been handed over to the police, the association echoes the sentiments of the Prime Minister in hoping that Mr. Ramdani's attackers are caught and an example made of them so as to deter anyone else from attempting such a brazen act. Tutor calls on all principals to ensure that proper security protocols are followed for the entry of visitors onto the school's compound. In addition to the protocols already in place, Tutor advises principals that all visitors must be made to provide photo identification and to sign a visitor's book before entry onto the school's compound. Tutor hopes that such an incident will not happen again in any of our nation's schools.
Thank you very much, Mr. Dudai, for being here with us this morning and sharing with the listeners these very important comments. You have been listening to Tutor Speaks. You can contact us at president@ttuta.org. That is president@tutor.org. Or telephone Tutor's head office at 645-2134, 645-3825, or 663-2738. Or contact Mr. Dudai at 681-8057.